Eiko Ishioka. Born in Tokyo, Japan, primarily an artist, she was also an art director, costume designer, and graphic designer. Known for her work on stage, screen advertising, and editorial, she graduated from Tokyo National University of Fine Arts and Music and went on to have a successful career in advertising for big brands like Sushido and Parco.
I'm a production designer. Then if I receive the production design work, I do costume also, because of the costume is be a very important part of the set design.
Her first foray into film production design was for 1985 film Mishima, A Life in Four Chapters. It won her an award at Cannes that year for artistic contribution. Her unique work on the Japanese poster for Apocalypse Now inspired Francis Ford Coppola to hire her as a costume designer for the 1992 horror romance epic Bram Stoker's Dracula, for which she won an Academy Award. And here in costume design, she would find her calling. Ishioka would then go on to have a long-lived collaborational relationship with director Tarsim Singh. Together, they would go on to make The Cell in 2000, The Fall in 2006, Immortals in 2011, and finally Mirror Mirror in 2012.
He showed me all symbolism painters, especially he pointed to the famous Klimt painting, which titled The Kiss. Eiko, is it possible to realize this painting to one of the Dracula's costume?
Ishioka was an enthusiastic collaborator and was always excited when all the different creative departments of a film would work together. And this is reflected in her work, where the costumes not only enhance the set, but sometimes actually act as the set themselves. This is demonstrated pretty impactfully in The Cell, where the intimidating character of Karl Stargard is depicted as a sort of evil king in his own mind, which we saw at the start of the video. Collaborations with the actors were also important to Ishioka, as she often had close relationships with actors to make sure they felt comfortable in her often extravagant designs, but also that they felt the emotion she was trying to bring out in her designs didn't hinder the physicality of the actor but enhanced it. This relationship led to a lot of evolution of the character, particularly the character of Lucy, played by Sadie Frost in Bram Stoker's Dracula, where Ishioka attended the rehearsals, and with talks with Sadie, it was decided that she'd crawl around on the ground like a lizard in her enormous wedding gown. After it was explained to Sadie that Eiko had designed it inspired after the Australian frill neck lizard. Ishioka has also designed for stage. She designed costumes for Wagner's The Ring Saga at the Dutch Opera, and was nominated for 2 Tony Awards for her costume designs for the Broadway play M. Butterfly. She's designed costumes for Cirque du Soleil, and she was also the costume designer for the infamous Broadway musical Spider-Man Turn Off the Dark. She was the director for the costume design for the opening ceremony of the 2008 Beijing Olympics, and she's designed Olympic uniforms for Swiss, Canadian, Japanese, and Spanish teams for the 2002 Winter Olympics. She's also created costumes for Grace Jones's Hurricane Tour in 2009 and directed the music video for Björk's song Cocoon in 2002. I love Ishioka's work so much, because when you see her work, you can see the evolution but continuation of themes and visuals. As an artist first, you can see that she has a very strong vision. But as such a keen collaborator, she's always open to challenges and to strong inputs from those that she's working with, which result in her style being shown, but through different lenses of directors and other creatives that are involved.
Tarsim and I decided the basic concept is hybrid classic. So I can use a hint of the soul from 16th century to 19th century, and plus Eiko's Art Nouveau, Eiko Nouveau, and Tarsim's Freedom Vision. So all cooked together is a special stew.
But her style's always there, as a sort of heartbeat moving along different people's creative journeys. Her designs always have a timeless quality that seems somewhere between fashion and art, and I think that comes from having such a range of influences and having started from a place of art but never being tied down to one particular sort of creativity.
Shouldn't be old fashion. I want to keep design timeless.
Ishioka died of pancreatic cancer in Tokyo in 2012. In 2017, on what would have been her 79th birthday, she was honored with a Google Doodle. She's made such a big impact on costume design and production design as a whole, and inspired so many designers that have come after.